Willi. It is recommended, also what I read about it, to be rather on the right side. So right now we are on the left. It for sure gets a wee bit trickier up here, reaching the summit. Hi everybody, today we're in Glencoe again and we're doing a Scramble Grade 2. This is a broad buttress which we can see behind us, and to the left of it over here is a Great Bully buttress, and this is a North buttress. We parked our car at Altener Feld, at the car park over here, then walked just here all the way up, and here's like a wee crack in a waterfall with a tree, and here comes now a path which will lead us probably up here. Yeah, the weather is not the most pleasant today. It's like 14 degrees. And yeah, between no wind and the wee bit wind. So the wee beasts are out. Really evil. And this is the first big step, and we are going now up here and then in this one. Yeah, it's like, you know, one day you have too much wind and you need to turn back, and the other day you have no wind and you have all the wee beasts. It's really like difficult. Oh, it's probably just a germ. I mean, I could use some of the repellent, but it's like not really too keen in the feel of it, on the skin. It's like the same with sun cream. Yeah, of course, you need to put it on, but I rather sweat more and have long stuff on, instead of putting like sunblocker on, which is really, I don't know, just not like the feel. But obviously there comes a time when you have to. So we're just going up here. Careful with the rock. It's again the slimy bit on top. So rather slower but safer. Wow, this wie beasts. And here we can see nicely the Great Gully buttress, how it runs down into the valley. And this one is a Scramble 1/2, according to the book. So probably a really nice alternative to go down as well, when you want to avoid the tourist route. And this is the wall which we will tackle next. I really have the feeling that this one is the loneliest scramble on the whole bookie. So, have a look here. looks really good. Deeper. Let a look how we do that. To short swap my legs over, otherwise it's like things like this. This one hand are too awkward. Just try to avoid always the wet things. But there comes a trade-off between super big steps and the grips where they are. And so also brilliant, we got a slight breeze. So no, it's not nice. So the midges are for the last few minutes gone. Oh, I need to walk just quicker. So, and this is how it looks now in front of us. So, but I try to avoid the slabs. They are, you can't tell it in this video, I think, but they are much steeper here than they look like. It's probably 45 degrees plus. So I think the better option is we go over here the rock bits to avoid the slabs. Probably I say it with every tour, yeah. But this one is also one of my favorites already. Purely to the effect that it's a really faint path only. And I don't know if actually a lot of people are going here, I don't think so. So it's a type of lonely. And really fun. And as a feeling, the rock gets just better with every step up. He gets sharper or grippier. Just brilliant. And here I really like 1,000 of different routes up. Really. Nice. So. I think it is recommended, also what I read about it, to be rather on the right side. So right now we are on the left one, because I think the view to the north buttress is just stunning. It for sure gets a wee bit trickier up here, or at least the one which I picked. but soon we have done the first wall here, the second bigger wall. I'm not entirely sure how far we have to go because my watch is a GPS. Somehow it's mad what it tells me. It said like when we started or right now, it says we are at 1112 meters, which can't be. I mean, the bookie isn't even this high. I really like when things like this happen, when the clouds or the fog are pulling up. And we are just heading up here. A fresh breeze over the edge. It seems to be that this is the scramble up the broad gully. The North Buttress, such a beauty. So we will head now short up to the bookie. Then we are going down the curved ridge. Reaching the summit. Stop jog. Oh, and down here we can see the Crow Baby Tower, which is our next aim. We're going now down the curved ridge. I will link you the video up here when you want to see it. And I hope you enjoyed the video as much as I did the scramble, and hey, see you next time. Bye.